all my colleague officers, all distinguished guests, members of media. We were not present when the First World War took place. We were not present when the Second World War took place. But all of us are witnessing what is called the Third World War, in which perhaps never in the past, in the history of mankind, such large number of people were affected by a fear called COVID-19. The war continues. So far, 195 countries are affected, which is much more a figure than any pandemic, any war in the past. The latest being the youngest country in the world, which has become the member of United Nations just 1 month before the COVID started, that was South Sudan. This war is very unique. No bullets were fired, no ammunitions were exhausted, there was no law and order situation anywhere, but still the entire population initially was asked to remain indoors. It was called Janta Curfew. And subsequently, in a phased manner, the government issued relaxations so that life could continue. We have entered now the 50th week of this pandemic spread. And now the United Kingdom has started the vaccination drive last Tuesday. A UK grandmother has become the first person in the world to be given the Pfizer 19 jab as part of the mass vaccination program. USA has supply chain issues, as has been reported in one of the articles of World Health Organization. The supply chain issues have made US government slash the vaccine production target for this year by 50%. The vaccine has to be maintained under the cold chain of minus 70 degrees Celsius. The country's dry ice production is not matching the requirement. This is of USA. One can imagine the situation in the developing countries which may emerge. We in India have lots of hopes from Bharat Biotech, Serum Institute, and Pfizer for vaccine supply. So far, 1.6 million, 16 lakh deaths have reported worldwide. In India, 142,000 deaths have reported so far. The surprising thing is that nearly half the people who have died of this virus in India are younger than 60 age. Sir, yesterday we had a safe city talk in the city. Under the Safe City Project, Hyderabad City Police conducts periodic talk in which experts are called, and we are doing this online because of the present situation. And in this, the subject yesterday was pandemic and mental health. And we were surprised that once hundreds of people were linked through the webinar, they were asking so many questions which were touching upon the issues of mental health, and the experts answered them to the satisfaction of most of the people. We in Hyderabad, we have our own uniqueness, as if history has repeated itself. In the early decades of the last century, there was a massive flood in the city when Musi was almost 10 feet above the main road on either side of the Musi near High Court and Usmania. That was followed by what was called Spanish flu. One century later, this time we again had both of them in quick succession, though in reverse order. This time the pandemic came early and the flood later on. The journey of Hyderabad City, and particularly Hyderabad City Police, during these challenging months has been quite memorable. This is the reason we have tried to document the chain of events with pictures and narrations, which soon will look quite historical once the country is completely out of this pandemic. I remember, sir, the early visits of all the senior officers led by our Chief Secretary himself to important and vulnerable areas like Mallepalli, where the Chief Secretary, Sri Somesh Kumar sir himself, visited and planned everything so that the spread gets restricted. But for the initial effort of the government, perhaps things would have been much difficult for us. The GHMC Commissioner, the Hyderabad Collector, the entire team of DMHO, 24 hours were the frontline warriors, and most of them were also got infected in the process. So was the state as far as police department is concerned. The task was uphill, but Hyderabad City Police, from the first day itself, they were ready to go. Whether it is the issue of identification of each and every train passengers coming from all the big cities, the profiling of passengers, identification, where they are staying, who all have got symptoms, we were not having any experience or expertise of this kind of work in the past. None of the police academies, none of the training centers trained our constable officers about contact tracing, about the primary, secondary, tertiary contacts. I remember in the earlier few weeks when one of the officers reported that what was called super spreader, three women within a span of 5 days infected 150 people. So that was the situation which created so much of fear in the early weeks. We remember that time has come to tighten our belt and tighten it for a longer period. I remember when Gandhi Hospital required the support of the local police, without any hesitation, 150 constable officers were ready to go and perform the duty inside the ward of each and every floor of Gandhi Hospital. That was the dedication. That was the commitment of all the officers of Hyderabad City Police. When we move to the next phase and what is called the containment area, there was a time when in the city almost 350 plus containment zones were declared, in which arrangement of essential items, milk, food grain, medicine and other things were coordinated with the help of GHMC and Hyderabad Collector. We ensured that not even a single house should face inconvenience as far as essential goods are concerned. I'll give one small example, sir. The average daily consumption of green vegetable in Hyderabad city, being the fourth largest city in the country, is 21 tons. And during the lockdown period also, with the help of all the departments, we ensured that the supply never goes down below 18 tons. So that was the effort, coordination under the leadership of the government. Each and every department were working so that there is no shortage felt anywhere in the city. Another important landmark, which perhaps is as historical as the event itself, is the issue of migrant laborers. Hyderabad being the hub of construction activities, hub of business activities, very few cities in India has as much of migrant labor as Hyderabad has. And I remember once the government took up the decision, under the Chief Secretary, series of meetings took place and more than 100 trains, special trains, started from Hyderabad to various parts of the country, including Northeast and Jammu and Kashmir. The record was made when, in one night, more than 40 trains moved from Hyderabad. And the video which some of the migrant workers, they circulated on the social media once they reached their place, their villages, in UP, in Bihar, in Odisha, in West Bengal, that was generating a lot of emotion. That when I remember our CM's statement that aap hamare economic development ke pratinidhi hain, you are the representative of our economic development, and it is our responsibility to see that not even a single stomach should remain empty during the pandemic period. Definitely it was an issue which was unprecedented, and there may have been some shortcomings here and there, but seeing the volume of the work, I think no amount of policing work in the normal sense would have given as much of job satisfaction as this year has given to all of us. In each and every mode of our work, community was there. I remember when in West Zone, at one of the places where large number of transgenders live, and transgenders are generally considered to be little neglected in the society, they are never taken care of, but the local officer, the DCP West Zone, had organized a special program only for tying up the transgender group with local NGO for supply of food material. The statement of some of the transgenders still lurks in the mind with lot of emotional content. I remember another incident, sir, when one of our DCP East Zone mentioned that a couple from Boston whose baby, 1 year old baby, had a birthday and there was nobody to celebrate. We went there and it was such an emotional gesture to celebrate the birthday following all the precaution, and the parents from Boston joined the thing online. So these are the emotional things which I am sure all the police officers would remember forever. All of us were on the same page, and that was the need of the hour. Every department was working hand in hand, overtime, night, day, and all the 24 hours, marching ahead like soldiers in a war. Fear of a danger lurking united us, united the entire city, and united the effort of each and every department collectively. This was a threat to mankind, and hence the entire mankind was united. I am reminded of a quote of a poetry from a famous poet, Ramdhari Singh Dinkar, who says, "Jo laksha grih mein jalte hain, wahi surma nikalte hain." The ones who are pushed to wax houses to get burned, like the Pandavas in Mahabharata, only they become the ultimate warriors. And these are the ultimate warriors as far as Hyderabad City Police is concerned. I take this opportunity to convey our gratitude to all our guests, and thanks to all the officers for coming here.